Oh, beautiful structure. I love brick buildings. They just seem very substantial to me. I like the look of the buildings, and I just think they have sort of like a timeless quality to them. Like 50 years from now, they'll still look good as well, as long as you take care of them, but the look itself will still stand up. So. Anyway, I'm in the downtown Pikeville area. Downtown Pikeville, Main Street. I guess this is Main Street right here. There's the University of Pikeville, or UPike as they call it. They have a park right there. So the place in the middle of the downtown area. It's a small university, but I mean, a university is a university. I like it when cities have universities, because it shows that there's at least some options for the poor people. A lot of times you get into a certain area and there's just not a lot of options. But you know, I also appreciate industry. Interesting enough, they actually call that building the coal building. Shows you how much influence coal has had on this area. Appalachian News Express, the newspaper around here. It's interesting. I look at the newspaper and I see things like their top stories. Their top stories will be very different from the top stories we'll have in Flint. Like, for example, they had on the front page a car accident. A story about a car accident. Just a regular car accident. And I mean, things like that. Whereas in Flint, it'll be murder, you know, things like that. So, excuse me, murder. In Flint, stuff like that wouldn't even make the paper. So it shows you that obviously the crime isn't that high around here. Another brick building. I liked that little train building right there. They're using a coach as a building. Kind of a clever idea right there. And there's the construction. Now when I look at stuff like that, I just think, I mean, that's how this whole area got here. That's how they got the entire area here, doing that type of construction. The work it takes to build anything around here. Anyway, guys, some of you guys probably been asking what I've been up to, and essentially I've been working, continuing to work, still saving up. Well, not really. I'm basically buying my vehicle. And my strategy is to essentially pay $600 every paycheck, $1,200 a month, and pay off the vehicle as fast as possible. The reason why I'm doing that is because I want to avoid bills. You know, the less bills you have, the more flexibility you have if something happens, if there is an emergency. Plus, it gives you freedom to go anywhere you want to go, whenever you want to go. You don't want any debt to tie you down. But sometimes it's unavoidable, especially if you want to buy a house. I definitely think if I buy a house, it would have to be in an area where housing is pretty affordable. Something like Indianapolis or somewhere reasonable like that. Flint has some great deals on houses, but where's the jobs? I mean, but this is sort of like the university area. Hilton. Hampton. I try to get out to the range every once in a while, but I don't get out there as much as I used to. Mainly because, you know, money's kind of tight. while I'm trying to just basically hurry up and pay off this vehicle. Oh, I did make some changes. One of the things I did was I had the tires checked. I also put in some new ceramic brakes for my vehicle, and it needed it too. The brakes were very much wore out. There's still something left, but I don't like to let things get to the point where they're really falling apart and it can actually damage other parts of the vehicle. And when you're dealing with brakes, if you don't take care of that in a timely manner, you can end up with an issue where, you know, your rotors get destroyed. And that's definitely something I want to avoid, because that can get much more expensive. But I didn't go cheap on the brakes. I actually acquired some good brakes. Offices, all these businesses and the houses and everything sort of packed in tightly. It's definitely not a place you want to be driving a big truck in. If you're going to be living inside these areas, these narrow streets, you definitely want to have a small car. Even that Escalade is kind of big to be squeezing in areas like that. That car right there might be a better option, but anyway. Yeah, I want to give you guys an idea of what the streets look like, at least within Pikeville. It's very, very narrow, not a lot of room. And another problem is that in the winter, if there's a lot of snow, which they don't get a lot of snow around here, but if there is a lot of snow, you know, it could be kind of difficult to get out of your driveway. Whereas if you're in a more open area, you have more room. But, oh wow, that house is beautiful. It's a historic house. It's beautiful. Look at that. Man, I definitely need to walk a lot more. You know, when you go a long time without walking on a regular basis, you can feel the difference. But anyway, there's the old courthouse. Yeah, it's just where I'm at. There's no sidewalks. And for me to walk, I have to be in an area where there's sidewalks that I can walk down the street and see what's going on. I can't just walk around in a circle over and over again. That doesn't seem very appealing to me. And there's a jail.